All right, I'm almost down to my last panful. Leave a brine when they have started eating, because Leela has to run to the store before Hobby Lobby closes at 8 o'clock. And they're not open tomorrow. But what I wanted to show you is when you put it in a pan like this, even if you're using a bigger pan, they'll run together. And if you wait just a few minutes, they'll come apart real easy. And all you have to do is just take your spatula and kind of run it along that edge, and I could wait just a little bit longer right here and that wouldn't tear. I thought it was ready, but it's not. So what I was going to show you, actually it didn't work, but if you're not impatient like I was, let that cook just a little bit more along that edge when you run your pan, your spatula underneath the edge along there. It'll come apart like that. In a good seasoned pan, it won't stick. And what I like to do, even when your pan is centered, those outside edges don't cook as fast. So when it's about halfway through cooking on that side, I'll spin it around and let it brown more evenly before I flip it. And then hopefully I don't have to flip it one time. And this is what's left over here out of that about cup and a half. But, you know, you have to do some tasting while you're cooking to make sure your salt ratio is correct. So I probably ate 3 or 4 pieces, and Brian had a piece, and they've got some at the table. So I probably had at least twice that meal. And when you see this start browning like this around the edge, you know it's getting pretty close to turning. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn that so that edge that's not cooked quite as much stays in the center. And that was the side on the other side that wasn't cooked as much. That way it'll be browned more evenly. Another thing to point out is I've added oil to the pan probably 4, 5, 6 times, a little bit at a time, 3 or 4 tablespoons probably at a time. You can see it's not like a lot of oil. You don't want to deep fry them, but you need to keep enough oil in there so that when you put your cornmeal batter in, it spreads out good and bubbles up, and you get the lace cornbread. If your pan is dry, it won't do that. But you have to have some oil in there. You know, it has to be enough in there so when you put it in, it spreads out and bubbles up to get that lace effect. So anyway, that's the end. This is the last video. Hope it works out for you. Post some pictures when you get finished. And if you have any more questions, give me a shout.